Yo, what's good, guys? Amen. Say, man. This is the Amen Show, back at it again for more NBA and NFL content. In this video, we finna talk about Drew Brees. Drew Brees in the game he has played in the NFC divisional game against the Super Bowl winners in the Tampa Bay Bucks with Tom Brady on the roster was his last game of his career, or we thought that it was his final game of his career because there was some speculation of him not fully considering retirement even though he almost retired just last season, and all of known that it was his last season of his career in 2020. He may surprise us and come back for his 21st season of his career. Who knows? But for his age being 42 years old and his throwing ability, let alone prime, is way behind him, I don't think that he's going to come back for the next upcoming season. He needs to just call it a career because, guys, look, if he's going to come back for his 21st season, it's not like he's going to lead the offense to the top 5 offense in the league like he used to in his early years. Obviously, and in fact, you can make the case that Hill, as the starting quarterback, the offense was still as good, if not better, because of Taysom Hill's ability to be a threat in the running game and a better arm with being as accurate as Brees in the 4 games he has started, as they went 3-1 with him losing to the Falcons by a field goal. Regardless if he comes back or not, I think it's a good time to make a career tribute to Brees' career. And where do we rank him at? Not only in the all-time quarterback list, but in the all-time players list. That is what we're going to discuss in this video. Where do we rank Drew Brees all time? Coming up. And oh yeah, before the video starts, make sure y'all subscribe to my channel for more NBA and NFL content in the future, as the majority of y'all are not subscribed to my channel. Turn on post notifications, all these things that help my growth in this channel. Anyways, guys, stay tuned and cue the intro.
I got this shit from the trap, you baggies, my pen and my pad. I done got rich off a rap, you throwing, we sending them back. That shit is a fact, my young boy ain't got no ID on him, he had to slip through the back. Go in the back. They took everything he had off his body, he thought he was lit cause he rapped. Gotta hustle, go get off your back. He broke, go get him a pack. I just blew 10 up in sacks. Fuck cops, they kill if you black. You might get a deal if you nice. Gelato, I'm smoking to give you the feeling you feel when you feel on the flight. Light up that blunt, go willy that bike. This is our life.
It's the lifestyle that we cherish every day. Taking risks, take out this cash in every way.
Drew Brees is one of the greatest quarterbacks in NFL history and a for sure fire first ballot Hall of Famer, as he is a 13-time Pro Bowler, made the All-Pro team once, a Super Bowl champion, and a 2-time recipient for the Offensive Player of the Year award. Not only that, he is the all-time leader in passing yards and completions, and also is top 3 in completion percentage. That tells you that Brees is the most accurate quarterback of all time, due to his ability to pick apart defenses because of his high football IQ, and you can make the case that Brees is the most clutch quarterback of all time, as him alongside Brady and Peyton Manning are top 3 in the most game-winning drives in NFL history. Drew Brees has been an incredible leader for the Saints for over a decade and a half, and his ability and knowledge to know how to win football games is almost equivalent to the likes of Tom Brady. For y'all would know that Brees didn't start his career in the Saints uniform. Actually, Brees was drafted by the Chargers by that time, where the Chargers were at San Diego with the 32nd pick in the second round in 2001. In the same draft where Michael Vick will be the first quarterback taken in this draft class, as he will be the first overall pick, and initially that was his Chargers first overall pick, but traded away their pick to Atlanta for their 5th overall pick. We all know how great he will be in his career, as he will be one of the most polarizing, most dynamic, and entertaining players in NFL history, and is right now the best dual threat quarterback of all time. But when it's all said and done for Lamar Jackson's career, I think that he will take that mantle of the greatest dual threat quarterback of all time. But that's another discussion for another day. And not to mention the other great players in this draft class, as LaDainian Tomlinson will be drafted with the 5th overall pick, at which the Chargers acquired in the Falcons trade prior to the draft, and he will later become a future league MVP and a first ballot Hall of Fame running back for the Chargers, and drafted in the same draft class alongside Brees. And then other great and Hall of Fame caliber players like Santana Moss, Richard Seymour, Reggie Wayne, Steve Hutchinson, and Chad Johnson, who was drafted after Brees. The 2001 draft class has talent, as it featured some players who are Hall of Fame caliber, and for some contributed right away for their respective teams. But for Drew Brees, he had a slow start for his career as he barely played in his rookie year, as he was the backup for a 39-year-old Doug Flutie who had a very subpar season. Although he threw for over 3,000 yards, but he threw more interceptions than touchdowns, completed in lowly 56% of his passes despite a great offensive line. The following year in 2002, where Drew Brees will become the new starter for the Chargers, and then the rest is history, as in his 10th year with the Chargers as the full starter, he accumulated 12,127 passing yards for 79 touchdowns and threw 53 interceptions. There were times where Brees was inconsistent, including the year in 2003, where he had the lowest completion percentage of his career and the lowest touchdown score of his career. Also, and he even got benched for the remainder of that year after a 1-7 start. But luckily, in the following year, he will turn everything around, and in that 2004 season will be one of the best seasons in Chargers franchise history, as the Chargers will go 12-4, being the first seed in the AFC West, with LaDainian Tomlinson already establishing himself as a top 3 back in the game, and most importantly, Brees will improve to become a top 15-10 quarterback in the NFL, as in that season, he will pass for over 3,000 yards for 27 touchdowns and 7 interceptions, with completing 66% of his passes. He will earn Comeback Player of the Year and will make a Pro Bowl appearance, but the Chargers will have a heartbreaking loss in the wildcard game against the New York Jets by a field goal. So what now? Drew Brees will become a free agent in 2006, and he wasn't thinking about returning with the Chargers after the 2005 season because they will eventually have a future franchise quarterback in Phillip Rivers and spend more money on the future starter. So it doesn't make any sense why he will stay with the Chargers, although he will have another solid season in 2005. The Chargers didn't give him the money that he wanted in the offseason. Therefore, he will sign a 6-year, $60 million deal with the New Orleans Saints, and that pretty much jump-started his career. As in 11 consecutive seasons where Brees will accumulate over 4,000 yards, and he will have 4 seasons where he will throw for over 5,000 yards and ultimately lead the league in passing yards and touchdowns in these 4 seasons, and also will have the highest completion rating in the league. Brees in his prime was absolutely absurd, breaking countless franchise records throughout his time with the Saints, and based on these stats and play, you can make the case that Brees was the best quarterback in the game between the early to mid 2010s, and not to mention the season in 2009 where he won his first and only Super Bowl, as the Saints will go 13-2 in the regular season, being the first seed in the whole entire NFC, where Brees will put up his usual numbers of throwing over 4,000 yards and score a league-leading 4 touchdowns, and will have the highest completion rating in the league. He will finish as the runner-up in MVP voting, Offensive Player of the Year, and the All-Pro selection because he was behind the likes of Peyton Manning, who received all of these rewards. But in the entire playoffs, Brees will prove why he's the better quarterback because compared to both of their runs, Brees will throw more touchdowns, has a higher completion rating, gone sacked less times, and even in the Super Bowl at which they face, in the Super Bowl with having one of the greatest quarterback matchups in Super Bowl history, two future Hall of Fame quarterbacks and MVP candidates going off against each other, Brees in that game had the upper hand as he scored more touchdowns and had a higher quarterback rating than Manning in that game. And coupled with Brees winning the Saints with their first Super Bowl in franchise history, along with Brees winning Super Bowl MVP, it's upsetting how great of a season Brees had in 2009 because he should have won all of these awards I mentioned earlier in this video because he put up slightly better stats than Manning that year. But the reason why Manning won is because he won one more regular season game than Brees. That is one of the biggest MVP robberies in NFL history. So far in his career in 2009, has won a Super Bowl, been a Pro Bowler 4 times, and even making an All-Pro team in 2006, has been named Offensive Player of the Year, and also won Walter Payton Man of the Year in the same season when he won a Super Bowl. Brees at this point of his career in just 3 seasons with the Saints has been one of the most successful players in the game, and not only in the past decade but in history in just a short amount of time within a 10-year with a team. And the only 2 players who also play in the same position with Brees who has been more successful than Brees is, you guessed it, Tom Brady and Peyton Manning. All three of them in the current state of the NFL in 2009 are three of the faces of the NFL, and later in their careers will retire as not only first ballot Hall of Famers, but as three of the greatest quarterbacks of all time. Well, it just came true somewhat. Three of them is for sure is going to be a future first ballot Hall of Famer, but the difference is that Brady will win four more Super Bowls and eventually become the GOAT. Manning will have five more elite seasons, including an MVP, which marks his fifth MVP, which is most of all time, and will win his second Super Bowl. But for Drew Brees, that's the reason why he is not considered a top five quarterback of all time. It's because of his second half of his career. Drew Brees in his second half of his career hasn't had as many postseason success as the two quarterbacks I mentioned in this video, and there was a time where between 2014 to 2016, he didn't make the playoffs in three consecutive seasons. It's largely because he never had a defense that has been consistently great throughout the second half of his career. Even this team in 2011, at which Brees will have his best statistical season of his career, as in the 2011 season, Drew Brees will complete an insane 71% of his passes for 5,476 yards with passing for 46 touchdowns and only threw 14 interceptions. The man yet again had the legitimate case for MVP, and should have been MVP if Aaron Rodgers didn't exist. Drew Brees lead the league in passing yards, completion rating, and passing touchdowns. He broke six NFL records that year. Brees had one of the greatest quarterback seasons of all time as he led the single season record for passing yards until two seasons later where Manning will break the record in 2013. Also, Brees will have his best team possibly in his career as Brees will have two 1,000 yard receivers in Jimmy Graham and Marquise Colston and other solid receiving options in a top 3 offensive line in the game. And once they get it going, they are pretty much unstoppable as they were smacking teams left and right, and this is the reason why they went 13-3 and placed 3rd in the NFC Conference. They took care of business against Detroit, winning 45-28, and after that win, they were looked upon as the favorite to win the Super Bowl that year. Their offense has been the best so far in the postseason that year, but the reason why the team hasn't gone out of the divisional round is because of their defense. The Saints defense has been struggling throughout the season, and looking at the stats, they were one of the worst in the league, despite the offense carrying this team, and that's the reason why they lost against the 49ers in the divisional round, despite being a classic rivalry between the two of them. And both of them throwing lights out in the game, they lost by a touchdown because the defense couldn't stop Alex Smith from completing the last five passes in the last minutes of the game. Despite all the woes, Brees in the 2011 postseason will rival the numbers he pulled up when he won a Super Bowl, as in the two postseason games he had played, Brees completed 69% of his passes for 928 yards and 7 touchdowns with 110 quarterback rating. Brees will always have weapons at his disposal to flourish in the offense, but he never had a defense that has been consistently been a top 10 or even above average defense throughout the second half of his career, including in the 2012 season where the whole Saints organization is dealing with a bounding gate scandal, where earlier in Brees' tenure with the team were paying out bonuses to their defense to injure other players on opposing teams, and that's the result of Sean Payton getting a one-year suspension despite multiple coaching changes during the season. Brees will still continue to prove why he's a top 5 player in the league, as he will pass for over 5,000 yards and over 40 touchdowns despite having his second lowest completion rating of his career, with only completing 63% of his passes. But the Saints missed the playoffs roughly due to coaching changes and yet again an heinous defense. Drew Brees has put up amazing stats throughout the last six seasons, but he was just overshadowed by teams that are just better than the teams that Brees have. And not only that, he just hasn't been as successful than the likes of Peyton Manning and Tom Brady, as them boys has consistently made the postseason every single year consecutively, and that is unfortunate because Brees' play is among the elite quarterbacks in the game. All he needs is a great defense or a solid defense for Brees to contend every year. At least the Saints did address this by hiring a new DC and changing the defensive lineman to 3-4, and then turn the Saints will have a top 10 defense in the game with their offense still as great as ever, but they lose against the Seahawks in 2013, who will later win the Super Bowl that year. Drew Brees never had a postseason where he will blatantly underperform. But in the 2013 postseason, Brees was still putting up numbers somewhat in the postseason, but he was inaccurate. Well, because he played against a Seattle Seahawks defense that is one of the best in history, and they were at their peak. And like I mentioned, Brees will not make the postseason in not one, not two, but three times. In part because they have a lackluster defense, especially with the secondary. And at this point, there are quarterbacks like Luck, Roethlisberger, Aaron Rodgers, who are putting up numbers as great as Brees, but they are leading their teams to the top seed in each of their divisions. And that will ultimately hurt Brees' career because he hasn't had that postseason success in his second half of his career. And that third missed postseason will start to frustrate Brees, even though he is putting up elite level stats every season. But now Brees will get what he needed to win. As in the 2017 draft class, the Saints struck big in the 2017 draft class as they drafted Marshawn Lattimore with the 11th overall pick out of the Ohio State University. And also in the first round, they'll draft Ryan Ramczyk with the last pick of the first round. And then in later rounds, they'll draft Alvin Kamara, Trey Hendrickson. The Saints in the 2017 draft class is one of the best in the franchise history. Nah, scratch that. That's 2017 draft class is the best draft class that they drafted in franchise history. And even adding last year where they drafted none other than Michael Thomas himself, where in later seasons he will have one of the greatest wide receiver seasons of all time, Selton Rankins to pair with Hakeem Jordan and Von Bell. Drew Brees has all of the pieces for him to succeed, and he still didn't win a Super Bowl, let alone make a Super Bowl appearance, despite him getting up there in age. In the next three seasons of Brees' career will be nothing but heartbreak and disappointment, excluding in the 2018 season where the Saints, most importantly Brees, have one more legitimate chance to make it to the Super Bowl. As you can tell from the stats that Brees had, he had the highest single season completion percentage of all time, throwing for almost 4,000 yards with 32 touchdowns, with the second lowest amount of interceptions thrown for his career. Y'all can tell that he is on a mission and still has some on the tank, as they will advance all the way to the NFC Championship game, where unfortunately the Saints were hit with by far the worst missed call in NFL history. And looking at that time after time again, we see this clear pass interference call. I mean, have these refs gone blind? If they just called that foul, then the Saints will should have advanced to the Super Bowl and beat the Patriots, and Brees will get his second ring, because the Saints had a better team than the Patriots that year. But anyways, Drew Brees in 2017, 2019, and the season that recently ended will see him have one wildcard exit and two divisional round exits, and including that one blown ass play by Marcus Williams against the Vikings in the 2017 postseason. But in 2019 and 2020 were unacceptable by the Saints by losing against teams that are inferior to them, like the Bucks and the Vikings. And for Brees in the last two postseason games of his career, it just looked like he just doesn't have that championship DNA that he used to in his early years. Therefore, he will have one of his worst postseason games of his career. So for his playoff career, Drew Brees went 9-9 in all postseason games while throwing for 5,366 yards for 37 touchdowns and 15 interceptions while completing 67% of his passes. So where do we rank Drew Brees all time? It's tough where we rank him because there are so many Hall of Fame quarterbacks that legitimize the game of football in so many ways, and some are one of the greatest winners in NFL history. Drew Brees' career has been remarkable, and he should be ranked as a top 12 to 10 quarterback of all time over guys like Roger Staubach and maybe over Dan Marino, because this is a guy who's a Super Bowl champion plus a Super Bowl MVP and had 11 seasons where he threw for over 4,000 yards and 9 seasons where he threw for over 30 plus touchdowns while being top 3 in completion rating. Not to mention that Brees never won an MVP in his career, which is a tragedy within itself. He is the all-time leader in passing yards and pass completions, and second all-time in completion rating behind Deshaun Watson. Brees is by far the most accurate quarterback we have ever seen, and his longevity is up there with the all-time great quarterbacks. The reason why he isn't a top 5 quarterback of all time is because he hadn't made a Super Bowl appearance since 2009, let alone didn't make the playoffs for 3 straight seasons, and even playing with one of the most talented rosters in the NFL, he still couldn't manage to make a Super Bowl appearance. And plus, he is just not as talented nor successful as a Peyton Manning, Aaron Rodgers, and Tom Brady. All three of them are better players than Drew Brees because they have more winning seasons, let alone won more Super Bowls and MVPs than Brees. And had Marino won a Super Bowl in 1984, where he arguably had the greatest quarterback season of all time and led the Dolphins to the Super Bowl, and hadn't faced the dominant 49ers of the 80s and got a Super Bowl ring, then he would for sure have been a top 5 quarterback of all time and over Drew Brees. It is crazy how Brees played for 2 decades in the NFL and has been so great for so long. Give the man the respect that he deserves, because I feel that Brees is a little underappreciated because all of the flaws that he has in his career, which I mentioned early in this video. Some people rank him at 14 or even 15 in the all-time quarterback list, which is pretty disrespectful. I mean, Drew Brees is one of a kind quarterback, a guy with a career that us NFL fans will cherish forever, and I don't think that we're going to see a quarterback who is as accurate as Brees for a very long time. And that is the video. Make sure y'all give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more NBA and NFL content, and also turning on post notifications by clicking on the bell notification on the right hand corner, sharing my video to y'all fams, all of these things that helps my growth in this channel. And that's always, guys, this is the A-Man Show, signing out.